Hello students, very good morning. We are learning the chapter acids, bases and salts, right? And in the previous class you have learned about properties of acids and uses of acids. And in today's class we are going to study about another interesting topic, that is base. So students, you might have seen your mother put salt and a pinch of another white color powder while making yummy pakodas, right? What could it be? It is a baking soda. So even your mother will add to dosa or some other baking items, for example cake. So for these kind of food, so she'll add this baking soda. So students, you take a pinch of that and find its taste. Does it taste salty or sour or bitter? So its bitterness confirms that it is neither an acid nor a salt, because you know that in the previous class we have learnt about acids, right? So acids always taste sour. Uli namge uli ano taste gotagutte. But so these bases always gives us a bitter taste, and even it is not a salt. Why? Because it doesn't taste like a salt. It doesn't taste like a salty. So such substances which have a bitter taste and a feel soapy to touch, they are called as bases. So when you touch these bases, you feel like you're touching a soap. Hence they feel like a soapy when you touch. So these are called as bases. And most of the bleaches, so bleaching powders and soaps, toothpaste and a cleansing agent or a cleaning agent contains bases. And some other examples of bases are sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide's molecular formula, that is NaOH. In simple, we'll write it in the form of chemical formula. Okay, sodium means Na, hydroxide means OH. It is a sodium hydroxide, that is the molecular formula of sodium hydroxide. So you know water molecular formula is H2O, right? In the same way, sodium hydroxide nothing but NaOH. It is also called as caustic soda. This you can found in a soap. Okay, next one is calcium hydroxide. So this calcium hydroxide molecular formula is CaOH twice. Calcium means Ca, OH twice means hydroxide. Okay, and it is commonly called as lime water. So sunna da neeru maneli iruttalva yaradru maneli sunna id madavidre gottirutte nimge. So that is called as lime water. Next is ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide molecular formula is NH4OH. NH4OH is a molecular formula of sodium ammonium hydroxide, and it is also called as ammonia water. It is also in the common name, it is called as ammonia water, and it is found in a window cleaners. And next one is sodium bicarbonate. So this sodium bicarbonate formula is NaHCO3. Okay, it is in base. That common name is baking soda. So we'll use it for the baking purpose, even for a cooking purpose, right? So baking soda, it is nothing but sodium bicarbonate. So these are all some of the example for bases. Look at this, children. So these are the examples of bases. So baking soda, so cleansing agents, soap, these are all the examples of bases. So let us see the properties of bases. You know that bases taste bitter. Okay, it is the presence of a base that gives unflavored milk of magnesia. You know that milk contain magnesium, right? So it gives unflavored milk of magnesia its bitter taste. And bases feel slippery. Slippery means jarudu anta. So but some drops of window cleaners between your fingers, you can feel the slippery feeling of a base, right? Suppose you can take soap also. So if it is there in between your fingers, you feel slippery, right? Feeling, it is a feeling of a base. And that is why detergent or soap left on a wet floor makes it slippery. Alva, so you most of have experienced this. Ivaga enadru floor mele elladru athwa detergent agirbodu soap enadru swalpa idre, so you feel slippery, jaro tara anusute nimge. That is due to the property of a base. Next, all bases are not soluble in water. Okay, they are not, they are actually soluble, but not all the bases are not soluble in water. So bases which are soluble in water, they are called as alkalis. Okay, they are called as alkalis. Even these bases are also called as alkalines. Okay, that because so if the bases are soluble in water, they are called as alkalis, and they produce hydroxide ions. So in the, you have previously learnt, right? So NaOH, so that is hydroxide. I told sodium hydroxide means NaOH, right? So Na is a metal, sodium is a metal, and OH ion is there, no? That is a base. Okay, they produce hydroxide ions in water. And next one is, bases react with acids to form salt and water. Look here, students, when this acid mix with a base, so it will give salt and water. It means, so when these bases react with the acids to form a salt and water. And next is, strong bases such as caustic soda and caustic potash are corrosive and dangerous to skin and eyes. Okay, so these strong bases and they tumba power ironta bases, so such as the caustic soda and caustic potash, they are corrosive and dangerous to skin and eyes. So this is about the properties of bases. Next, we learn about uses of these bases. So ammonium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide means NH4OH. It is used as a window cleaner, right? It is a base which generally dissolves grease and they help in eliminating the stains and tarnishes by reacting with oils and fats. Okay, ಇದು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೀಸ್, ಗ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಫನ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಲೀನರ್ಸ್. ಹೌಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಲೀನರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಮನೇಲಿರುವಂತ ವಿಂಡೋಸ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಡ್ರೈನ್ ಕ್ಲೀನರ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಮೋನಿಯಾ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಚಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್. ಸೊ ಚಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಬರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಡ್ರೈನ್ ಕ್ಲೀನರ್ಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಮೋನಿಯಾ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಚಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಂಟಾಸಿಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎನ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಟು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಅಸಿಡಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್. ಇದೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಆಂಟಾಸಿಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಆಗದೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ, ಸೊ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಂಟಾಸಿಡ್ಸ್. ಇವಾಗ ಜಲೂಸಿಲ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ತಗೋತೀವಲ್ವಾ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಗೆಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಂಟಾಸಿಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಟು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಅಸಿಡಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್. ನಮ್ಮ ಅಸಿಡಿಟಿನ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಾ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಂಟಾಸಿಡ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸೋಪ್, ರೇಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಪ್ಸ್, ರೇಯಾನ್ ಫೈಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಪೇಪರ್. ಸೊ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬೇಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಅಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಲೈಫ್, ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಫುಡ್ ವಿ ಈಟ್ ಟು ದ ಸೋಪ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಅಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಸಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. While bases, you know that when bases dissolve in a water, they're called as alkalis, right? Alkalis are alkaline solutions. And the substances which are neither acidic nor basic, they are called as neutral substances. Okay, so ivaga kelavondu substances irutte, for best example is our water. So namge water na kudidaga we won't feel it is salty, or it won't feel like it is acidic, or it is sour or bitter. We feel like it is pure or like sweet, right? So this is called as neutral substances. Okay, the substances which are neither acidic nor basic, acids alla bases alla, so that kind of substances are called as neutral substances. So pure water is a neutral, pure water is neutral. So these are the prop uses of bases, and today we have learnt about bases, properties of bases, and where we will use this bases. Let us learn about some info bit in your textbook. Okay, the chemist Robert Boyle, he was the first one differentiated the substances into either acids or bases. You have to remember his name, Robert Boyle. And every substance has another unique characteristic, it is pH value. So how can we test that whether the solution is acidic or basic? With the help of this pH value. So pH means power of hydrogen. So the pH of a substance is indicates its level of acidity or alkalinity. So the pH value, okay, this is the values of pH, that is the pH value ranges from 1 to 14. Okay, 1 in the 14 varugu irutte ee pH scale. The pH scale used for measuring the acidity and basicity of the solutions. So this pH was invented by Sorensen. Okay, it was invented Sorensen. Here you have to remember, if the solution is acidic means, so it contains more hydrogen. If the solution has more H plus ions, that is hydrogen ions, than this hydroxide ions, it is considered as acidic. Okay, idra navenadru H plus ions jaasti idre adanna acidic ions anta karithivi. And if it is considered as acidic, then the acidic solution has a pH value less than 7. Okay, less than 7 irodike, so acidic anta karithivi. You know that from 1 to 14, so we have a pH scale. From 1 to 7, that is acidic, and 7 is actually neutral. It is neutral, and from 7 to 14, it is called as base. Okay, so if we get the value of 14, that is strongly basic. If we get the value 1, when you test that, so that is, it is strongly acidic. Meaning, okay, if it has a OH minus ions, so you have studied, no? So NaOH, OH means, OH ions means basic, calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice, right? OH, nothing but it indicates it is a base. Magnesium hydroxide, hydroxide ions, nothing but OH minus. So this indicates that this is a base. So yeah, you have to remember, if a solution contains more hydroxide ions than hydrogen ions, it is considered as alkaline. So previously we have learned, so if hydrogen ions jaasti idre, H plus ions jaasti idre adna acidic antare, OH minus ions jaasti idre adna enanta karitare, so it is called as base. And the basic solutions has a pH value greater than 7. So less than 7 idre acidic, more than 7 is basic. If it is 7, that is called as neutral. And if the amount of hydrogen ions equals the amount of hydroxide ions, suppose if H plus ions and OH minus ions are equal, the solution is considered as a neutral. Yaake antandre H plus ions mate OH minus ions. Students, you know that H plus ions means acidic, right? OH minus means basic. So when these two combine, it becomes water. So you know the value, you know the pH value of water, that is 7. 7 means neutral, right? If the amount of hydrogen ions equal the amount of hydroxide ions, the solution is considered as neutral. And a neutral substance has a pH value of 7. Water is a neutral substance. So these are all some interesting facts about acids and bases. I hope all of you have understood the topic. Thank you.